dying Christ destroyed our death. Rising, Christ restored our life. Christ will come again in glory. As in baptism, Alvin put on Christ, and so in Christ may Alvin be clothed with glory. Here and now, dear friends, we are God's children. What we shall be has not yet been revealed, but we know that when he appears, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is. Those who have this hope purify themselves as Christ is pure. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and I am the life. Those who believe in me, even though they die, yet shall they live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the first and the last. I died, and behold, I am alive forevermore, and I hold the keys of hell and death. Because I live, you shall live also. Comfort, O comfort my people, says your God. Speak tenderly to Jerusalem and cry to her that she has served her term, that her penalty is paid, that she has received from the Lord's hand double for all her sins. A voice cries out, in the wilderness, prepare the way of the Lord. Make straight in the desert a highway for our God. Every valley shall be lifted up, and every mountain and hill be made low. The uneven ground shall become level, and the rough places a plain. Then the glory of the Lord shall be revealed, and all the people shall see it together, for the mouth of the Lord has spoken. A voice says, cry out. And I said, what shall I cry? All people are grass. Their constancy is like the flower of the field. The grass withers, the flower fades when the breath of the Lord blows upon it. Surely the people are grass. The grass withers, the flower fades, but the word of our God will stand forever. Have you not known? Have you not heard? The Lord is an everlasting God, the creator of the ends of the earth. He does not faint or grow weary. His understanding is unsearchable. He gives power to the faint and strengthens the powerless. Even the youth will faint and be weary, and the young will fall exhausted. But those who wait for the Lord shall renew their strength. They shall mount up with wings like eagles. They shall run and not be weary. They shall walk and not be weary. Out of the depths, I cry unto thee, O Lord. Lord, hear my cry. Let thine ears be attentive. to the voice of my supplication. If thou, Lord, should mark iniquities, Lord, who could stand? But there is forgiveness with thee, that thou may be feared. I wait for the Lord. My soul waits, and in his word do I hope. My soul waits for the Lord more than those who watch for the morning. O Israel, hope in the Lord. For with the Lord is great mercy. With him is plenteous redemption. And he will redeem Israel from all their sins. Now I would remind you, brothers and sisters, of the good news that I proclaimed to you, which you in turn received, in which also you stand, through which also you are being saved. Now, if Christ is proclaimed as raised from the dead, how can some of you say there is no resurrection of the dead? For if the dead are not raised, then Christ has not been raised. If Christ has not been raised, your faith is futile, and you are still in your sins. Then those also who have died in Christ have perished. But in fact, Christ has been raised from the dead, first fruits of those who have died. But some will ask, how are the dead raised? With what kind of body do they come? Fool, what you sow does not come to life unless it dies. And as far for what you sow, you do not sow the body that is to be, but a bare seed, perhaps of wheat or some other grain. But God gives it a body as he has chosen. What is sown is perishable. What is raised is imperishable. It is sown in dishonor. It is raised in glory. It is sown in weakness. It is raised in power. It is sown a physical body. It is raised a spiritual body. If there is a physical body, there is also a spiritual body. When this perishable body puts on imperishability, and this mortal puts on immortality, then the saying that is written will be fulfilled. Death has been swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? But thanks be to God. Thanks be to God. Thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. My brothers and sisters, we gather here today to celebrate the life of Brother Alvin Galloway. But as we gather to celebrate the life, we come together in grief, acknowledging our human loss. But as we gather, we also come to worship the Lord, who is able to mend our broken hearts, the one who is able to lift up our heads and wipe every tear away from our eyes. And so now we will proceed with this worship service as outlined in the program. We will have our opening selection by Ms. Shermelle Lockman.
God is our strength.
Amen.
like no other.
Amen.
And he is the one that reaches out to all of us, even in our times of weakness, in our times of sadness. He is the one that we can lean and depend on.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, at this time, let us join in together as we pray the Lord's Prayer, followed by the 23rd Psalm. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. At this time, we will have the reading of the 23rd Psalm. Coming from the King James Version, it reads, "The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He maketh me to lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for thou art with me. Thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest the table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil. My cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." Our New Testament reading this afternoon comes to us from the Gospel of Matthew, chapter 9, verses 1 through 7. And it reads, "And he entered into a ship, and passed over, and came into his own city. And behold, they brought to him a man sick of the palsy, lying on a bed. And Jesus, seeing their faith, said unto the sick of the palsy, Son, be of good cheer, thy sins be forgiven thee. Yes. And behold, certain of the scribes said within themselves, This man blasphemeth. And Jesus, knowing their thoughts, said, Wherefore think ye evil in your hearts? Well, whether it is easier to say, Thy sins be forgiven thee, or to say, Arise and walk. But that you may know that the Son of Man hath power on earth to forgive sins.
Amen.
Then he said to the sick of the palsy, Arise, take up thy bed, and go unto thy house.
Yes.
And he arose and departed to his house." This is the word of God for us, the people of God.
Amen.
Thanks be to God.
Amen.
Let us pray. Dear Lord, our Heavenly Father, we come to you this afternoon asking you to do what you said in your word. Where two or three are gathered together in your name, you promise to be in the midst.
Yes.
But God, you also promise to inhabit the praises of your people. So right now, God, as we have gathered in this celebration of life, for Brother Alvin Galloway, God, we ask you to be in the midst of us.
Yes.
God, move from heart to heart and breast to breast. God, right now, today, God, we ask you to surround us.
Amen.
Surround this family with your presence and your peace. God, lift up our heads. Wipe every tear away from our eyes. God, send your spirit to comfort us. Send your spirit to strengthen us. Send your spirit to bring us peace, which surpasses all understanding. God, we ask you to have your way this day.
Amen.
Have your way, God, so that when it's all said and done, God, you get the glory. God, you get the honor. And you get the praise. God, we're believing that you're going to do this. And we count it done in Jesus' name. Amen.
Amen.
At this time, we will have remarks by Brother Greg Hammond.
Just before I give my own personal remarks, I have a letter of condolence from the St. Thomas Chapel Pentecostal Holiness Church, Greensboro, North Carolina. June 7th, 2021, to the family, the pastor and elect lady, the deacon board, missionaries, and the membership of St. Thomas Chapel Pentecostal Holiness Church, extend our heartfelt condolences to our members, missionaries Sonia Watlington, Lionel, Deacon Larry Galloway, Elder Melissa, and Christopher Galloway on the passing of their brother, Mr. Alvin Dovane Galloway, who transitioned to his eternal resting place on June 1st, 2021. May God's healing touch rest upon the hearts of your entire family. We encourage each of you to allow God's healing promises to sustain you during the difficult days ahead. He promises to never leave us nor forsake us. In John 14:1-3, the Lord tells us, "Let not your heart be troubled. Believe, if ye believe in God, you also in me. In my Father's house are many mansions. If it were not so, I would have told you. I go to prepare a place for you, and if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and receive you unto myself. And where I am, there ye may be also. For the children of the Most High King, life does not end, but is eternal through Jesus Christ. Our prayers rest with your family. In sincere regards, Bishop Tyrone D. Hunter, Pastor, Deacon Burley Levette, Jr., Chairman, Dory L. Lane, Church Secretary." For God so loved the world,
amen,
that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth on him should not perish but have everlasting life.
Amen.
I'd like to extend my condolences and my deepest sympathy to the family. I can't say I know how you guys feel, but I think I got a pretty good idea because I share your loss. Alvin was a very dear friend to me. I've been thinking all along, what could I say? And if you knew Alvin, there's a whole lot that could be said. A whole lot that could be said. But I know there's a time constraint, and I'm going to do my best to stay as close to it as I possibly can. I met Alvin while junior high. We got to know each other, and we became friends. And we've been friends ever since. Even while I lived away, we kept in touch. We kept in touch. When I came home for holidays or various other occasions, I knew I had somewhere to lay my head if I needed to.
Amen.
One thing about Alvin was we shared a mutual respect. We learned to respect each other. It didn't start out that way, but we learned to respect each other. And one thing about it, he knew if I had, he had, and vice versa. We liked the same things. Alvin liked nice cars. Although, we called mine Bombo. I don't know why y'all laughing. You know, you saw the word for Bombo. You said, yeah, Bombo to me. shop, we like to go out and eat. Another thing that we never did was, when we went to eat, I paid last time, your time, okay? We didn't do that. We would grab the bill. I would do the tip, or vice versa. Alvin was one of my best friends. And it's been said that if you're fortunate enough to have one true friend in your lifetime, you're blessed. I want you to know I stand here right now blessed because I knew Alvin. Alvin knew me. We were dear, dear friends. Had some long, passionate conversations. We cried together. Well, most of the time with me crying. But we had deep conversations and we respected each other enough to say, hey, I don't agree, but we were still good.
Amen.
I'm gonna miss that guy. I'm gonna stop. I'm gonna miss that guy because I would say I've had two true friends in my lifetime. Alvin was one. And although I'm gonna miss him, I'm gonna try not to well up over this. I have no doubt in my mind.
Praise the Lord.
That I'm gonna see him again.
Amen.
You know why? Because he joined that whosoever believeth family before he closed his eyes.
Amen.
Alvin, rest well, my brother.
Amen.
So many great memories with him.
up to between him and Broderick. And my family, my mom, dad provided a great life for us, but to see Broderick and Al move the way they did and get what they want out of life, to go after what they want and what they desire, really inspired me. So Al, I'm gonna miss you. He was the first one that introduced me to beer.
It's a few of us that's here from Zong's. We worked with Al for a long time. And Al was our friend. Yeah. And even when he left Zong's, he still stayed our friend. Mm-hmm. And I was really close to him. He would call and invite him to his house. And I'm going to really miss him because he was my friend. And I just want to thank y'all for sharing with us.
If there are no other remarks, at this time we will have a selection by Brother Christopher Calvin.
Faith to remove the unmovable. Faith.
Faith.
Somebody said faith.
Faith.
That's what it takes, y'all. We give honor to God today.
Amen.
To Pastor England and all the ministers of the gospel that are here. To my family. To all my cousins. And to all of you that are here today. This great celebration of the life of Abby. Let me also give honor to these bugs I've been fighting since I've been here. Them some bad bugs. You know, cuz as I was sitting back there on that standing against that table, I was looking around and I said, I don't have no right to complain about nothing. Because as I look around, even as Abby is leaving us today, but still there are others right among us. And we ought to just thank the Lord for being in the land of the living one more time. As it already been said, Abby was just. We used to joke with one another about dressing. You know that rascal could dress.
Amen.
And that's where we talked to each other. He could dress, he would look at me, he said, cousin preacher time. Don't I look good? I said, you don't look no better than me. He said, oh yes I do. You know, it's good to have people to talk to and laugh. We got so many folks, frowns all the time, like they ain't got nothing good to say.
Yes, sir.
But Alvin was a person that even he had his ups and downs, rounds and rounds, like anybody else.
That's right.
But he would smile, if you didn't watch it, he would make you smile.
Yes, sir.
Yes, he did a lot in life, it's already been said. And we thank God that the Lord have blessed him to do some things to help others. Amen?
Amen.
Now I'm going to leave Alvin alone. Now he done lived his life.
Amen.
He's in a God, good God's hand. This COVID-19 virus, the reason we ain't here, sickness, the death had carried a lot of people away, other sickness. But I want to read this scripture here in 1 Corinthians, chapter 15, the 24th and the 25th and 26th verse. The word says, then cometh the end. When shall I delivered, he shall have delivered up the kingdom of God, even the Father, when he shall have put down all rules and authority and power. For he must reign till he has put all enemies under his feet.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The last enemy that shall be destroyed is death.
Yes, sir.
Amen.
Amen.
Amen. Death. Family, I just want to leave these few words with you here. Death is still on the move.
Uh-huh.
A few days ago, death stopped by Alvin bedside. But death just didn't stay there with Abby.
Mm-hmm.
Death kept on moving. Because since death stopped by to see Abby, there has been many have gone on.
Yes, sir.
Death is still on the move.
Yes.
One thing about death, I said, we can't stop it.
Yes, sir.
Even if Abby told death no, death said, yes, you got to go. But you can be sure that death will show up. Stop all of us on this tedious journey.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And you can run, but you cannot run with it.
Mm-hmm.
Because it will sooner catch up with you. Amen?
Amen.
I tell you, it seems like it's so hard for some people to come to understanding that we all are going to die and leave this earthly world one day.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
And I say that because the way people are living in this world, There are people living like they are going to stay here forever. Y'all can say amen if you want.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
You might think this is your home down here. Mm-hmm. But this is not your home down here. We're just passing through.
Yes, sir.
This old earthly journey for just a little while.
Yes.
My Bible tells me man is born on a woman of a few days.
Yes, sir.
And those days are full of trouble.
Uh-huh.
But I come to tell you that trouble won't last always. Because death is still on the move.
Yes, sir.
One thing about it, family, Alvin won't have to worry no more.
Uh-huh.
He won't have to worry no more about trouble, trials, and tribulations.
Yes,
he won't have to worry about no more hospitals, no more sickness.
Yes, sir.
He won't even have to worry about this old world's ups and downs.
Mm-hmm.
Because the other day, the Lord, I said, the Lord, oh, death to move Alvin from all worldly things of this life.
Yes, sir.
And I got news for all of us. Alvin can do nothing different than we got to do.
That's
one thing is, Lord God, we all got to move one day.
Yes, sir.
There is one of these old days, death's going to be knocking at all our
doors. Yes, sir.
In other words, we all got to leave this old world.
Yes.
Because death is still on the move.
Yes, it is.
Although death is still on the move, I tell you, that's not the main issue here.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
The main issue is to be ready when death catch up with us.
Yes.
Jesus said in the Gospel of St. Matthew 24 and 44, therefore, be also ready.
Yes, sir.
Because of the word says, after death, then comes judgment, heaven or hell.
Yes.
And I tell you, there's no pastor, there's no minister or preacher.
Yes.
Can preach no one in heaven. I can't preach you out of hell.
Yes,
I tell you, time is winding up. I'm almost through here.
Yep.
Time is winding up. According to God's word, we're living in the last days.
Yes,
and I don't believe we got long to stay here, y'all.
Yep.
Because the signs of the last days are here now.
Yes,
death is still on the move.
Yes,
while we're still living in this last day, we ought to be getting ready to make heaven our home.
Yes,
it don't make no difference who you are, where you are, or where you're going or where you're coming from.
Yes,
you might be rich, you might be poor, but old devil's gonna show up, knock at your door.
Yes,
come on, somebody.
Yes,
look what the scripture says in Hebrews 9:27. And as it is appointed until men wants to die and then the judgment.
Yes,
and you can assure, I don't care what people say, there's one appointment that we can't cancel.
Yes,
I tell you, the last enemy, the word says that shall be destroyed is death. But death gonna be around here a mighty long time.
Yeah.
In other words, we ought to be getting our house in order.
Yes,
right now, while death is still on the move.
Yes,
Alvin done lived his life. The book is closed on Alvin down here.
Yes.
But we are still down here on this teacher's journey.
Yes,
and while the blood is still, help me, Holy Ghost, still running home in our veins, we ought to be getting closer to the Lord to make heaven our home one day.
Yes,
and I don't know how you feel about it, but I feel, as the songwriter said, I'm just a pilgrim and a stranger, traveling through this barren land.
Yes.
But I got a home. Somebody say, I got a home.
I got a
beyond
home.
The city. Can I get a witness that you got a home?
Yes.
Beyond the city?
Yes.
Well, there'll be no more sickness and no more death. Over in Revelation, John said, Lord God, you ain't got to cry no more.
Yes.
You ain't got to die no more.
Yes.
No more trouble, trials, and tribulation.
Yes.
I tell you, that's a home, man.
Yes,
I tell you today, from the youngest to the oldest, you can hear my voice. And I know you can. You ought to be getting ready and getting right with God right now.
Yes,
time, I said, time is winding up.
Yes,
you ought to be getting ready to see God one day. Ain't God all right? God knows, thank you for the life that he gives me. But God is, I said, God is, he's a way maker. He can make ways. I don't know, man. I don't know about you, but I thank the Lord that he woke me up early this morning. I thank the Lord that he's starting me out on a brand new day. You'll get a witness. God is, he's a good God.
Yes, sir.
And death.
Amen.
And death.
Yes, sir.
Is still on the move.
Yes, sir. Amen.
Let's get right, family. Let's get right.
Amen.
And go home.
Yes, sir.
By every day it be Sunday.
Yes, sir.
And it's Sabbath. We'll have no evening.
Amen. 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 Amen.
move, I begin to think death is trying to outrun the Lord.
Yeah.
But he's not going to win.
That's right.
He's doing all he can, but the Lord is the one who's going to have the last word.
Amen.
And the final say.
Amen.
So as the preacher said, let us prepare to get ready so that when death comes knocking, we'll be where the Lord will have us to be. Thank God for this wonderful word today for this family. At this time, my brothers and sisters, we will have a service of committal. In the midst of life, we are in death. From whom can we seek help? Our help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth. God who raised Christ from the dead will give life to your mortal bodies also through the Spirit that dwells in you. Listen, I will tell you a mystery. We will not all die, but we will all be changed. For this perishable body must put on imperishability, and this mortal body must put on immortality. Then the saying that is written will be fulfilled. Death has been swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, you have ordered this wonderful world and know all things in earth and in heaven.
Yes.
Give us such faith that by day and by night, at all times and in all places, we may without fear commit ourselves and those dear to us to your never-failing love in this life and in the life to come. Amen.
Amen.
Jesus said, "Very truly, I tell you, unless a grain of wheat falls into the earth and dies, it remains just a single grain. But if it dies, it bears much fruit. Those who love their life lose it, and those who hate their life in this world will keep it for eternal life. Whoever serves me must follow me, and where I am, there will my servant be also. Whoever serves me, the Father will honor." And Almighty God, into your hands we commend your son, Alvin Galloway, in sure and certain hope of resurrection to eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. And this body we commit to the ground, earth to earth, ashes to ashes, and dust to dust. Blessed are the dead who die in the Lord. Yes, says the Spirit, they will rest from their labors, for their deeds follow them. And let us pray once again. Gracious God, we thank you for those we love but see no more. Receive into your arms your servant, Alvin Galloway, and grant that in increasing in knowledge and love of you, he may go from strength to strength in service to your heavenly kingdom. Through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
And now, my brothers and sisters, let us receive this dismissal. Now unto him who is able to keep us from falling and present us faultless before his presence with exceeding great joy, to the only wise God, our Savior, be glory and majesty, dominion and power, both now and forevermore. Let the redeemed say amen.
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 And amen.
Amen.
We'd like to take this opportunity to thank Reverend Eaton, Reverend Williamson, the solos that were here today, all the musicians, to each and every one that has participated in the service, and to all of you who have come out to show your love and support to the family during this time of bereavement, every act of kindness that's been shown and truly said thank you so very, very much. To the family, thank you for allowing us to share in your ongoing service, and thank you for allowing us to serve you. If there's anything we can do at a later date or any time, our service will not end today. Please feel free to call upon us. This concludes our ongoing service for our beloved Adam Galloway. May his soul be at rest in peace.
Amen.
May God be with you, family, keep you uplifted, and ask everyone to continue to pray for this family.
Amen. Amen.
And we ask that you all go in peace and God be with you. Thank you again for coming. And on your way, get your calls. Feel free to come out and greet your family. Thank you so much for coming.